This is another hurdle I encountered when I booted into CachyOS Live. CachyOS is installed, but I don't see Windows. Where did it go? Finally, we have CachyOS and Windows in dual boot without too much of trouble. Hi, I'm Abhishek and I have been helping people enjoy Linux on their personal computer for more than 10 years. And in this video, I'll share how I successfully dual booted the blazing fast CachyOS Linux with not so fast Windows 11. You will see a few hiccups I encountered in the process and how I overcome them. I got this Asus Zenbook a couple of months back. This is a premium looking laptop with excellent specification and decent pricing. After my initial rough experience with Ubuntu, I decided to try CachyOS as this is the distro everyone seems to be talking about. Spoiler, it is actually quite nice and fast. I don't have data to prove it, just my feelings. Anyways, my Zenbook came with Windows 11 Home Edition without BitLocker. I decided to keep it and install CachyOS in dual boot setup. Here is how it went. I used my Tuxedo laptop running TuxedoOS to create a live USB of CachyOS with Ventoy. The process is simple. Download Ventoy, extract it, and then run the executable. Plug in the USB and install Ventoy on it. For some reasons, I had to hit update after installing Ventoy to see it mounted. Creating live USB with Ventoy is as simple as copying the ISO file of the Linux distro on the Ventoy USB. That's it. Next, I plugged in the USB and pressed F2, F10 and tell button to enter the boot settings. I can never tell for sure which button works. In the boot setting, I changed the boot order and put USB at the top so that the system boots into the live USB. Okay, so now the system boots into live CachyOS USB. There are a few options here and I'll go with the default one. Just wait for it to do its stuff. Quick tip here. If you see this start job running for more than a minute or two, it could be problematic. In my case, I force rebooted the system and the live USB worked fine the next time. If it persists, you may try changing the USB port or have to create live USB again, or even dig deeper. Another problem I faced was at the screen. What is the password here? No one knows. I discovered it by trial and error. What I did is to change the display server to VLAN from X, and then simply click the next, and then simply click the next button. There was no password, but it didn't work with GRUB display server for some reason. And finally, I'm in the live session of CachyOS now. An active internet connection is mandatory for the installation. All right, everything seems to be set. Let's install CachyOS. And it tells me that I'm running an older version of CachyOS ISO, which is actually true because I had downloaded the ISO a month back. But I will still go ahead with this one. Next, it asks for the bootloader choice and I go with GRUB. That will cause a slight problem later. Stay tuned for that. Now, my system is not plugged into power source, but that's okay. This Zenbook has very good battery life. Alright, so we come to the most important part of the installation, disk partitioning. I was pleasantly surprised to see that Calamar installer recognized that the system has Windows installed already, and it gave me the option to install CachyOS alongside. And that's what I did here. I have a single disk that has Windows partition as well as the UEFI system partition on it. Things are smooth. It shows the current disk state and gives me the option to change it for CachyOS installation. I'll give more storage to Linux because it will be my main operating system. So now comes the interesting part, and this is why we connected to the internet. It gives the options to install various desktop environments and Windows manager, and it will be downloading them. This is why we need an internet. GNOME is my preferred desktop, so I go with it. And on the next screen, it shows me the packages it is going to install, which includes the CachyOS package, base devel package, and the GNOME desktop. Alright, everything seems to be set, and I hit install. And then I wait because it will be doing a lot of things here. The downloading will take some time depending upon the internet speed. I'm going to speed it up because this is a boring part, nothing of substance here. And we are done. Let's restart the system now. I forgot to take out the live USB, but surprisingly, it booted from the hard disk. Perhaps the boot order change I did earlier was not permanent. So, I have the CachyOS Linux installed now. I don't know if you can see properly, but the GRUB doesn't show the Windows Boot Manager entry. It's not proper dual boot, is it? Don't worry, I'll fix it. Let's log into CachyOS first. Typical GNOME stuff you might already be familiar with. So, let me fix the missing Windows entry from GRUB bootloader. Open the terminal. Oh, it uses fish shell. Wonderful. You see the autocomplete? That's the beauty of fish. So I'll edit the GRUB config file and enable OS Probe. As a security feature, OS Probe feature is disabled in GRUB, so that it doesn't look for other operating systems in the UEFI system partition. Just uncomment this line to enable OS Probe and save the file. Update GRUB now. Ubuntu's update GRUB is actually a very specific custom command which actually runs this GRUB make config command. So running this command will update the GRUB configuration. See, it has found the Windows Boot Manager and now it is adding boot menu entry for it. So everything is hunky-dory now. Let's restart the system once again. By the time I finished the entire procedure, my dinner was ready. Don't be scared. I was doing this late in the evening. Nothing alarming here. You don't have to wait this long for the CachyOS installation. Alright, now you can see that Windows Boot Manager is also available here. That completes this Windows CachyOS dual boot system. Actually, I saw some discussion that it is tricky to dual boot CachyOS with Windows. But it turned out pretty straightforward for me. Except a few small hiccups perhaps. I am loving CachyOS and the super smooth experience it provides. Stay subscribed, stay tuned for the next video, and I'll be sharing more helpful Linux tips and tutorials. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.